Hello, friends of the Northern Entertainment, and welcome to another episode of my another episode of my Flash and Light Let's Play. Today we are gonna have a quick look at the new calls in the fire department. The first one is starting right now, and that is this truck does not like to go around corners at all. But yeah, the first call that we have is a cat stuck on a tree. And that is probably... this is probably the most quintessential call that you would think of when you think about calls for a fire department. Is a cat stuck on a tree. That's one of those classics. It's just as classic as the hero fireman coming out of the flames with a damsel in distress in his arms. It's just as cliche, if you ask me, but I mean, it happens. It happens. I had it happen. Options here, of course, right now is we're gonna either cut the tree down or we're gonna use the ladder. And that right there brings us kinda to... there we go. Okay, on scene. That right there brings us then to our first problem, and that is, well, usually I would just use the ladder here, but not our first problem, but our first thing that I want to go through, and that is here the ladder that we have now. Now, I have not used this ladder yet. Now, where's the kitty? Hello, ma'am. North with the fire department. No cat to return. Yeah, no. Probably not. Oh, there's the kitty. There's the kitty. Look at that. Okay, so at this point, we are going to go for option two. This has almost some comic factor to it. Not to worry, ma'am. Kitty will be out of the tree in no time. Okay, then. Well, the cat is rescued. Pff. Oh, wow. Wow, wow, wow. Well, there is another thing that we have, and that is now traffic cones. And they are actually really nicely to use. Look at this. And apparently it's an endless supply of traffic cones. Oh no, it's not endless. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12... 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 20 cones. That is nice. Now, how does one pick them up, though? Oh, okay. They're easy to pick up, too. See? Not as easy as putting them down, but easy enough. And now I have to put them all up or pick them all up because... Well, safety first. No, but we are having a fire call or a call to a building fire. And that probably will be the last call for today because boy, oh boy, oh boy, this already was very strenuous on my poor brain to get this done. All right, let's rock and roll. That poor tree. Well, that cat will never climb that particular tree again, I can guarantee you that much. Now, as you can see, the vehicle AI is a little bit better in that they, for the most part, try now at least to let you go through. Come on. Come on. There we go. Alrighty. Oh yeah, there is a building fire indeed. Okay, there is yeah. Let's grab some hose. There's still no hose that we can use from the engine. But maybe eventually someday. I mean, there is... The good news is that the... excuse me. The good news is that the development is ongoing with this. And so... Eventually, I think we're gonna see... A more refined fire system. I mean, fire propagation systems are always... Well, for one thing, the most important thing of any simulator that wants to have anything to do with fire, but they are also the most difficult thing to get right. And I said that many times before. I actually programmed the fire system with a fire propagation system, a really simple one for Second Life for roleplay server. And that's when I realized how many things can go wrong and how easily you can create something that looks good but will absolutely crash every machine, like even a NASA computer, if you just don't put certain safeguards in. Like the fire system that I made pretty much could have grown, initially it could have grown to the size of a full sim. Now if you never had anything to do with Second Life, then that means nothing to you, but for those of you that had anything to do, yeah, in theory it could have grown on a total and on a complete sim, but or a region, I guess you could say, for a full server, it could have brought the server down easily. But yeah, I think that's it for the new special calls that we have for the fire department. I think there's only a cat. That's definitely it for, driver trapped, okay, well, we might as well take that one. yes, we are taking this one, thank you. Where is it, though? Oh, it's just on the highway. Okay. How we're gonna do this, yeah, alright. I'm gonna go straight through the city and then we're gonna take the next on-ramp. Do you see that big red truck coming towards you? Thank you. Ooh, that was close. I don't know why, but for whatever reason, driving first person in this one has some qualities of being a very satisfying experience. And the motor sounds when you are first person are not terrible. I mean, they sound like an engine with a... Or, no, it sounds more like a bus, but it definitely gives you this... it definitely gives you this vibe of... yeah, this vibe of being in a big engine with an automatic gearbox. Oh, it's the worst possible place you could do that, right? The worst possible place. Okay, we are on scene. Okay, well, since our colleagues from the police department didn't feel the need to do this yet, we are going to secure the scene first. Sorry, guy. This road is closed for now. I can't believe they did not close that road, honestly. I cannot believe that. There we go. That's good enough. Thank you. Okay, rescue equipment. Gotta love those battery-operated hearse tools. Alright, here we go. Let's do it. There's this typical cracking sound missing. Use the med bag. I think that's what the medics are standing by here for. They don't need me for that. I guess. Since the medics are just hanging out there, we might as well. If you don't mind. Oh, what? Why? Why you do this to me? Grab that bag. No, not the spreaders. No, we inspected the right arm. I have done it in so long. Come on. Alright. So what are you guys doing now? Oh, he look at this. He is a mime. Give me my medic bag. Thank you. Alright. Well, this concludes today's video. I do hope you guys enjoyed it, and let me know if you want to see more of Flash and Light. Unfortunately, there has not been much on the terms of medics, and the police is probably covered well enough already by others, but if you do want to see some more of that, then by all means let me know in the comments below. Until next time, this is the Northern Alex signing off. Thanks for watching, and God bless.